Hello guys, today I want to show you how to make a signal flare, very easy and using the simplest chemicals. This is yellow signal flare based on sodium nitrate. Also it contains sulfur and charcoal. This very old composition appeared to be much brighter than I thought. When I tested it the first time, I was surprised by its brightness. It was, well, just surprisingly bright for such simple composition that doesn't contain metals. Need to say a few words about why I choose this composition. Because if you have at least basic knowledge about pyrotechnics, you may remember a lot of much better and much brighter flare compositions. Yes, I know, there are a lot of much better flare compositions, even on YouTube. Unfortunately, they all contain metal powders and some chemicals that are not so easy to get. So they are not suitable for simple DIY projects that you can easily make at home. The second reason is that I couldn't find any simple flare composition on YouTube. Except, well, maybe smoke flare. I found a lot of smoke flares on YouTube. That is in fact not a flare at all, but just very primitive smoke bomb based on potassium nitrate and sugar. Okay, let's start to make our yellow signal flare. At first need to make a thin paper tube. It must contain only 3 or 4 layers of paper because it must burn within the flare composition. Then need to make a holder to hold your flare safely. Just fill the tube on one half with something, preferably not flammable. In this video I use wet gypsum, but it is not very convenient because it solidifies very quickly. Preferably to use something else, like bentonite clay or sand or even toilet paper. Yeah, you can fill the holder with just toilet paper, like I did in my big flares, and it will work too. Now it is done, let's prepare flare composition. Here is the composition. You need sodium nitrate, sulfur and charcoal. Sodium nitrate can be bought in garden store, hope or chemical supply store. Otherwise need to prepare it by yourself from ammonium nitrate and baking soda. The good thing is that sodium nitrate is not banned in some countries like potassium nitrate. So in this country sodium nitrate will be much easier to get than potassium nitrate. Sulfur can be bought in garden store. And charcoal. You can use barbecue charcoal or activated charcoal or any other charcoal you can find. This is not black powder and the source of charcoal doesn't really matter. All three ingredients must be grinded to a powder and then mix it together. If you use mortar and pestle, it is possible to grind them together. But if you use coffee grinder, better don't. Grind them separately and then mix together. When the mixture is ready, fill your flare with it. Take small quantities of flare mixture and use the wood stick to compress it. When the flare will be completely filled, insert a little piece of fuse on the top of it, then seal it with a cotton and paper tape. Okay, now you have little pen-sized flares. These flares are used mostly for testing. Before I tested some different yellow flare compositions, including even sodium nitrate based rocket candy. I cannot say nothing good about them, they just burn and that's all. Mentioned composition from sodium nitrate, charcoal and sulfur was the brightest. I made bigger flares by the same way but using bigger tools. Small pen-sized flare burns around 90 seconds. Big flare burns 2 minutes or more and give as much light as a whole campfire. It's really bright and it really illuminates. That's all for now guys, please like, comment and subscribe.